Well, well, well. Pretty ballsy showing your face around here.
I get to officially notify you that Internal Affairs is investigating all four members of your former strike team.
Well, you got burned trying to make that case already. Why don't you move on?
Since all the strike team's files, all your files on them are here, I'm going to be setting up shop in the barn until my investigation's complete.
You're kidding me, right?
Most of the time. Just not this time.
And where exactly do you think you're going to drop anchor?
Well, I need some privacy. And I don't want to restrict any of these officers from using the interrogation rooms. So the easiest thing for me to do is to use your office.
Hey, excuse me, Lieutenant. Are you forgetting that I'm captain here?
Acting captain. And that entitles you to a workspace and a phone, not a private office. So I understand the last captain did very well right here on the killing floor. Sorry for the inconvenience. Scott?
What the hell are you doing?
I know this will come as a big surprise to you, but you and your team are the subject of an IED investigation, which I am heading up.
You already lost face in front of the brass blowing our Russian bust. How's this play helping you?
I appreciate your concern, but let me worry about that.
Don't expect any cooperation from those folks down there. They're a home crowd.
I wouldn't want to do anything to upset them. Last thing I want to do is rock the boat.
Where the hell's our door?
The other one, too.
That son of a bitch.
Thought you might like a little fresh air. Let a little sunshine.
Pretty cheap stunt.
I assume you guys have got nothing to hide, right? Anyway, with all the confusion last week, I never did get a chance to congratulate you on that bust. Nice work. Even if it was a little unorthodox. But back to business. I need to see you in my office.
Not without my lawyer.
Becca Doyle. Huh? Good call. Let me know when she gets here.